on top of the throne. Yeah. I am a king of the pawn. Hop on a jet, cross the globe. Yeah. I guess the world is my home, and there's so many milkers burning my dome, and like turbulent air, I'm switching these flows. If you lick at my neck, boy, I'm letting it snow. I'm sturdy as hell, as a vessel saloon. They showing me love in my city. Gangs ain't hippies. Women like Nicki know what I'm about. I'm not the stereotypes. They do not fit me. I'm bigger than life. Give everyone jobs. I'm not a guard, but heart with a squad. I'm playing my part, but I'm LeBron. Rings of the team, I feel Jackson and hard. The homie calling from a cell. A couple of homies be making it. Making it. I just want all of them dudes to do well. And I'm worried about taking a couple of L's. No sin for me, just win for me. Don't kill for me, just live for me. Keep it real for me. We eat together, leave the bill for me. Like,
hand on my heart. I give it all I got. Walk the walk inside the talk. Take it higher, that's a god. Hand on my heart, know I give it all I got. Walk the walk, talk the talk. Take it higher, that's a god. Never stopping, that's a must. Always winning, never lost. GPS, I never lost. GPS, I never lost.
Who do it better than me, yeah? Vision on 2020, yeah. VVS, Clippity, yeah. Determination, laser focus. Banging on they, on they. Though they taking notice, taking notice, taking notice. Determination, laser focus. Banging on they, on they. Though they taking notice.
Rick Rock. Tip Doc. West Hip Hop.
Rick Rock Beats.
Are you ready for some football? Ladies and gentlemen.
Mississippi and New Orleans, Big Snoop Dogg got a Madden lead. His team is off the hook and you don't really want none, but if you do, come and get some. See, tell your mama and tell your daddy and tell the whole damn world this is Madden territory. Tell your mama and tell your daddy and tell the whole damn world this is Madden territory. Come get some if you want some, but you ain't bad enough, so you can't take none. I'm Big Snoop Dogg and I'm the only one, and when it comes to Madden, all y'all fools my sons. Bag up off me and watch it lose. Snoop Dogg is on the mic, I'm giving Madden blues. And if you choose to run up on me, you gon' get laid out so fast. Cause I can get you with the run or I can hit you with the pass. I can't be touched and I can't be schemed. Roll your when I'm in a mud league. 2-0, 2-0, Madden time on you suckers. Y'all can't get close, so why you wanna touch us? Cause my team is so hard, my team is legit. Madden 20, Snoop Dogg is, I get it. I got cleats on my feet, jersey on my back, helmet on my hair, ready to attack like that.
Down in Mississippi and New Orleans, Big Snoop Dogg got a Madden lead. His team is off the hook and you don't really want none, but if you do, come and get some. See, tell your mama and tell your daddy and tell the whole damn world it's Madden territory. Tell your mama and tell your daddy and tell the whole damn world this is Madden territory. Come get some if you want some, but you ain't bad enough, so you can't take none. I'm Big Snoop Dogg and I'm the only one, and when it comes to Madden, all y'all fools my sons.
Bag up off me and watch it lose. Snoop Dogg is on the mic, I'm giving Madden blues. And if you choose to run up on me, you gon' get laid out so fast. Cause I can get you with the run or I can hit you with the pass. I can't be touched and I can't be schemed. Roll your when I'm in a mud league. 2-0, 2-0, Madden time on you suckers. Y'all can't get close, so why you wanna touch us? Cause my team is so hard, my team is legit. Madden 20, Snoop Dogg is, now get it.
Big Snoop Dogg, it's in the game.
Let me find out. My team ballin', you look like you need a timeout. I'm a star, in the clutch, I'ma shine out. Working hard, yeah, I'm back on my grind now. Game on, took a loss, but I stay strong. Super Bowl rings, I just wanna play off. Gotta go hard, I can never play soft. Giant in New York, I run it back like Saquon. And I gotta win no matter what, like fourth down, Hail Mary, no punch, like every time I touch down, I gotta stunt.
Randy Moss, yeah, my number's going up. All these trophies, what do I need any more for? Check the stats up, you can check the scoreboard. Check the stats, Jay Critch, I'm the QB. Ran it up and then I went and got a new freezer. How fit to be the boss? Let me find out. My team ballin', you look like you need a timeout. I'm a star, in the clutch, I'ma shine out. Working hard, yeah, I'm back on my grind now. Game on, took a loss, but I stay strong. Super Bowl rings, I just wanna play off. Gotta go hard, I can never play soft. Giant in New York, I run it back like Saquon. How fit to be the boss? Let me find out. My team ballin', you look like you need a timeout. I'm a star, in the clutch, I'ma shine out. Working hard, yeah, I'm back on my grind now. Game on, took a loss, but I stay strong. Super Bowl rings, I just wanna play off. Gotta go hard, I can never play soft. Giant in New York, I run it back like Saquon. If you ain't a winner, then don't come round. On my way to another city, it's a touchdown. Under late, yeah, I gotta get it in a rush now. Let them hate, try to knock me down, but we got up now. You say that you ballin', keep it real though. Ay, why I never saw you in the field though? Ay, I make it look easy, it's a field goal. I've been grinding for a minute and I'm still going. How fit to be the boss? Let me find out. My team ballin', you look like you need a timeout. I'm a star, in the clutch, I'ma shine out. Working hard, yeah, I'm back on my grind now. Game on, took a loss, but I stay strong. Super Bowl rings, I just wanna play off. Gotta go hard, I can never play soft. Giant in New York, I run it back like Saquon. How fit to be the boss? Let me find out. My team ballin', you look like you need a timeout. I'm a star, in the clutch, I'ma shine out. Working hard, yeah, I'm back on my grind now. Game on, took a loss, but I stay strong. Super Bowl rings, I just wanna play off. Gotta go hard, I can never play soft. Giant in New York, I run it back like Saquon.
The young, incredible, honestly unforgettable. You a joke like Chappelle Show. This so perennial. Do this for my millennials. I be murdering any flow. I just had to let you know. It's the young, incredible, honestly unforgettable. You a joke like Chappelle Show. This so perennial. Do this for my millennials. I be murdering any flow. Yeah. I just had to let you know. Yeah. Give me that work and I can sell it. I put it on the line like I ain't selfish, nah. The story f***ed up if I let you tell it. Put my heart and soul in, so you feel it. I ain't never faking, I'm the realest since Tupac in the prison, man, claiming his innocence. Currently, I'm the greatest rapper in the sense. But any currency, I'm still guaranteed my wins. This is coming from within, I stuff for real, I don't pretend. When the OG spilling knowledge, better's best you soak it in. I'm a prophet to them scholars, got them chakras opening. Got them fixing up they actors, now they truly focused in, I'm seeing 2020 visions. Daily manifesting on my premonitions. Best to keep it neutral, got my own religion. The brainwashed, gotta make your own decision. My word is James Bond, I stay on the mission. Coming for the top position, ain't no competition, man. Pull up in the top, it's missing. The opposition ain't all that lane switching. This is what the game is. It's the young, incredible, honestly unforgettable. You a joke like Chappelle Show. This so perennial. Do this for my millennials. I be murdering any flow. I just had to let you know. It's the young, incredible, honestly unforgettable. You a joke like Chappelle Show. This so perennial. Do this for my millennials. I be murdering any flow. I just had to let you know.
Ladies and gentlemen, ladies and gentlemen,
are you ready? Are you ready?
Get ready, dog.
Ready, set, green light, go. Tires burn the pavement, people wanna know where Mace, Posse, and Dave went.
Still here, still in your ear with a style so hot, you'll see where all the sun rays went.
Legs, arms, the head, all being moved in a frenzy.
The blends be all the right cred.
Meaning credentials,
best of both worlds when we rocking over pearls.
In the instrumental,
are you ready?
It's time to get it lit, we got it hot like fever.
Sick with the talk, the pass of your receiver.
All about running the spot.
And you know we got breath control, so no need to take a breather.
Cardio kingpin,
subjugate the dub play.
And you know we can't wait to bring spins.
A-star quizzes, A-plus the final.
Vocals we align, we'll move it all
simultaneously over joints you rock.
We earn
30 years, so you can say we got
3 turns.
Live off the board, unlike you and your chess men.
We install doubt in you and your yes men.
And if the game had veins, we'll insert
jump to the rhythm as hard as you can go.
Keep it steady,
steady.
To the letter, right?
Bang.
Turn it up, y'all peak the flow.
But can you rock it like rocket fuel?
What you talking about? Space or out your mind?
But can you rock it like rockets, fool?
That's a close encounter of what kind?
Ready, set, steady, bang.
Then jump to the rhythm as hard as you can go.
Playing skills, you did.
Playing skills.
Ice on the wrist, car on the wrist, all on the wrist, watch how I flip, watch how I whip, I'm in the whip, all on the wrist, I never switch. Ice on the wrist, car on the wrist, all on the wrist, watch how I flip, watch how I whip, I'm in the whip, all on the wrist. I never switch, ice in the wrist, I get the money but I never switch. They saying you switch and you wonder. You know they came from the bottom and now we is lit. You was lit, I gotta get it, I gotta get it. You hating cause ice on the wrist. Why bitch you wanna be famous, they elevated us, you know I'm icy in Vegas. Just for the that haters, I make a lot of new money, when the not save us. You be liking my flavor, I think it's cuz ice on the wrist.
Since I blew, they all on my hey, back then, didn't know I exist. Don't touch my cup, you know how I sip. Hey, got your blown.
Welcome in, everybody. It's the coach. This is Madden 20 on EA Sports. Coming up next, we've got what should be a good one between the Denver Broncos and the Buffalo Bills. I'll have scores around the league for you at the half, but it's time for a little football. So we'll hand it over to our broadcast team, Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
From the home of the Bills since 1973, there's a look at the newly named New Era Field,
just outside of Buffalo, New York. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it, this crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the Denver Broncos and the Buffalo Bills. That'll be taken in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. So here come the Bills on offense for the first time. Commanding the offense will be the seventh overall pick of the 2018 draft. It's Josh Allen.
And you and I both know that any win is a good win, and that's what they did last week. But there's also plenty for him to work on in his game, wasn't there?
Yeah.
Two touchdowns, an interception. Yeah, you know, he wants to increase that a little bit in terms of ratio. But first and foremost, they did win the game.
Check 26.
A play fake to Singletary, and now it's Allen. Jones has it. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. A really good pickup of 28 yards. So a first and 10 now in Denver territory at the 47. Devin Singletary with his first carry of the game. And just no chance of turning the corner. He can only get back to the line of scrimmage. Second and 10 coming up. Now let's take a look here at the Bills' offense.
In the NFL, we love to talk about bloodlines and how important they can be. And for Zay Jones, he's got a terrific one. His dad, Robert, longtime linebacker in the NFL, big time with the Dallas Cowboys. And his uncle, Jeff Blake, a starting quarterback in the NFL at one point. Wonder if he played catch with Uncle Jeff in the backyard a few times growing up.
On second down, here's a run with Singletary. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. 11 yards there, first down.
That's a very nice game there, a confidence-building run. Love the execution up front, and the way he pressed the hole, absolutely perfect.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. Here we go. Working out of the shotgun, here's Allen. Looking right sideline, but it's incomplete. Defensively, we check the starters now for Denver. Now, they played extremely well last week in the win over Atlanta.
No matter what coverage was called, they were in the hip pockets of the receivers all game long. I mean, they were running the routes with them. Turned out, they were right there on every single ball thrown and came away with five interceptions.
They'll try again from the 36 on second and 10. To throw again, Allen. Into double coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Bryce Callahan.
That was a really nice interception. I think it illustrates the differences between playing man and playing zone. When you're in man, all you're focused on is the receiver in front of you. But when you're in zone, you're allowed to read the quarterback's eyes and go to the ball. That's exactly what happened on that play.
Carry for Royce Freeman. And he's going to lose yardage here. Back to his own 18. That's going to go as a loss of two, and it'll be second down. First play of the drive goes the wrong way. Here's second and 12. Here we go on second and 12. And that's incomplete. And as a first-rounder, a lot of eyes on him, a lot of expectations.
And he has to play well in his rookie year. Those days of coddling guys and bringing them along slowly, those days are long gone. When you're drafted in the first round, they expect you to play right away. And the community's eyes and fan base, they'll be on you the entire way.
And you take a look at this draft class from a season ago, really it grades out as a pretty darn good class.
So you have to give a lot of credit to the entire scouting organization, general manager, personnel department, college scouts. It all came together. They evaluated it very well and got a nice payoff.
And the play goes for 19 yards, gives them a new set of downs. After getting that turnover on the first drive of the game, you'd hate to just stall out the momentum, go three and out. They're able to avoid that there.
Yeah, we talk about complimentary football all the time, but I think it's a little bit deeper than that. Defense went out, forced a turnover, gave the ball to the offense. It's now the offense's responsibility to pay that off for them, to show respect to them. Hey, you guys got us a turnover? We appreciate it. They want to continue their drive. I know we love our jobs, and pretty much any play we see, we're pretty, you know, excited about. The big plays, let's face it, that's what we absolutely live for. How about that one?
That was great. And what our camera missed was the fist pump from the sideline after that catch. They're fired out. That's a big game.
Tighten up. 64, weak.
Off play action. Love. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down.
And it is true. You can draft the fastest. You can draft the most athletic guys. But if they don't know the art of positioning, sometimes it's all for naught. In this case, in the right spot, he'll force the incompletion.
Well, he had his hands on it for a second. Would have been a tough catch, though. Falls incomplete. Wide open receiver complete. That one a gain of 20 and a first down. Pretty solid start for the rookie here on this first drive, Charles.
Able to have some confidence, stepping back into the pocket, move around a little bit, find open receivers, and deliver. That just means his confidence is going to continue to grow because he's getting more and more comfortable with each completed pass.
They'll run here with Freeman. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Denver score. Royce Freeman, his second touchdown on the season. And they are able to strike first here on their opening drive. And they're able to run it in. It started with the battle in the trenches. They won there, and they got in for 6 points.
And that's going to be a tough one for the defense to deal with. They've got to go to the bench now and figure out how are we going to slow down this running game, because on that particular play, they had no answer.
The touchdown. Here's McManus now to kick it away. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Here's the Buffalo offense now as they get set to take over here. And there are parts of their last drive they'd like to emulate. And of course, they'd like to forget the inning, the interception. But they did put together, Charles, a nice sustained drive to get him down the field.
Yeah, and unfortunately for them, the only thing that matters is part two, right? Because once they threw the interception and finished off the drive, that does them no good to go back and say, well, you know, we had a good one going. Finish things off. That's the only way you can get it done. I think that's a big pickup for a first down, because when you run a drag route against zone, you're sometimes asking for trouble because you might run into a defender.
Yeah, well, there they ran into a first down, executed it to perfection. Here's Allen, and that's going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down.
They went with a dime look on defense, two extra defensive backs on the field, and covered up essentially every blade of grass. That allowed them to disrupt the play.
This is a draw play. Allen gives to Singletary. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. A gain of 13. It's a first down.
We don't talk about it very often, but sometimes there's a dip in intensity when you start the second half, which can manifest itself in some sloppy tackling. And how about right there? He ran right through that weak tackle attempt.
They will get 4 yards here on the first down run, and that'll make it second and 6. He was brought down there by Will Parks.
I call that play a success. A nice inside run sets up a very manageable second down. A very solid gain on that play.
They'll run here with Singletary. It'll be a pickup of a couple, and it leaves him with a 3rd and 3.
And the big fella stuffed that one up in a big way. I think doubling him has to be a priority, because you can't move up to the next level if you don't take care of him first.
Allen going to try and throw on 3rd down. And the throw there going to be incomplete. I know he wants to get his team back in the game, but a 50-50 ball right there that maybe was a little questionable.
Yeah, he's pretty lucky to get that one back. I think that sometimes these quarterbacks play with a lot of confidence that borders on arrogance, and that can put your team in some dutch.
Yeah, especially maybe want to look at some safer routes after the interception he had that ended their last drive. Well, he had that one on target. That's half the battle. The other half of the battle, however, is distance.
And he nearly had that, too. But it was a crossbar that said otherwise. And that'll deny him a shot at 3.
Ready. The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. And they'll be looking to make this a two-score advantage. Had the touchdown on their first drive, Charles. Hey, they can get up two scores here on the road. That's a heck of a start.
And not only have they thought about it, I wonder if they visualized it. I remember playing, and they used to turn the lights out in our meeting room and run through a situation like this and say, just think about what it would be like to be up on the road and take the crowd out of it. Maybe they did some of that.
After 1-7-0 on EA Sports. Broncos football as we begin quarter number two, as they've got it with a first and 10.
Come on, QB, come on. Topper. Go.
On first and 10, it's Lindsey. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
The last run good for two. Here's second and 8. Here's a give to Lindsey running right. And still about 3 yards shy of a first as the 4-yard pickup brings it to third down.
Well, they didn't get a whole lot out of that one, but I think you got to continue to try and run and try and keep the defense honest.
You mean, or else they'll just sit back, dare you to throw it on every down?
Yeah, you get your quarterback hit a lot that way, too.
Now the throw on third down, knocked away and incomplete.
Nothing open downfield, and he had to get that one out in a hurry because he just knew he was about to take a big shot. Probably couldn't get his legs into the throw. Became an all-arm throw, trying to check it down to his running back. Incomplete.
These kickers now, it used to be that a 50-plus yarder was cause for celebration, now seemingly automatic.
Yeah, isn't it funny? When we prepare for a game, when you look at the backgrounds of these kickers, it's interesting, isn't it, to find out they were All-State quarterbacks, receivers, defensive backs, All-State wrestlers, right? Baseball players. We're finding athletes all along, and now they're just specialists putting it through the posts.
Here's the Buffalo offense now as they get set to take over here. Last time out, they had that long 50-plus yard field goal that they missed.
And I'm sure on their sideline, they're thinking to themselves, okay, do we still want to try?
Oh, Allen cannot get away, and down he goes.
Brandon, if I'm an offensive coordinator and I see an all-out rush like that, I file it away because I'm going to use their aggressiveness against them as this game goes on. I'm going to hit them with a screen soon.
So that complicates things a bit here. 18 yards to go now on second down. Now Allen. Finding a safety valve here. That's complete. And he's taken down. It's a gain of 3 from the 17 to the 20.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware, ball may come your way.
On third and long, it's Allen. He's going to loft one deep left side here, and that will be incomplete. Well, they weren't scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up fourth down.
Not only was the call spot on, how about the execution of that defense right there? Zone was absolutely locked up tight. He was trying to force it in there on third down.
But if there's a time to force it, he felt like he needed to make a play, right?
Yeah, exactly right. Third down, you got to try and find something. There's nothing available there for him.
A good return there, call it 13 yards. And the Broncos take over, first down and 10. The Bills now making their way back out onto the field. And despite being down on the scoreboard, this unit, they've had some big-time hits.
Sort of like us at practice the other day. I saw you take a running start at that blocking sled. You took it down.
Bounced off like a rubber band.
No, not at all, but you're exactly right. They are doing their job, but they want to add takeaways to it. You need to have more of those to go along with the big hits we're seeing.
By the way, when I tried that and I bounced back, I noticed that you laughed with everyone else. You didn't try to get in my corner.
No. Someone had just told me a joke on the other side. Right, I missed it. Totally missed it.
Throwing to start the drive, but that went incomplete. Before the game, they were running the route tree about as efficiently and effectively as we could have possibly imagined. But sometimes the passes just go awry.
Yeah, let's face it. When you're running the route tree in pregame, you don't have defenders breathing down your neck. You don't have defensive backs making plays on the football. Hard to replicate the intensity of the game in pregame. Offensive linemen love creating space for their guys carrying the ball. But when that guy also breaks tackles and creates extra yardage, they almost feel like he's one of them, and they really embrace him.
Looking to throw. Love. Well, the two men come together, and it's incomplete. Excellent work defensively. Brings up fourth down. More problems here on third down. They've converted only once so far in this first half.
And you know as well as I do in this league, if you don't win on third down, it makes it hard to win a ball game, because then you're relying on your defense, relying on your special teams. You've got to get it done with your offensive unit.
And this one hits at the three and then bounds into the end zone for a touchback. Here's the Buffalo offense now as they get set to take over here. And three and out on the last drive. No points on the scoreboard. A little soul searching now.
I would say so, and they need to help out their defense a little bit. They've had to be on the field a lot more than normal, put them in some tough spots, but what's the old adage? When you get another chance, it gives you a better chance to do it right.
16 yards there, and the Bills have a first down.
That's pretty much meat and potatoes right there, wasn't it? Just go right at them and let your big horse charge up the middle. Not too fancy there, was it?
Nothing fancy at all. Challenging that defense, and on that go-around, the offense won the challenge. A running play here on first down is going to go nowhere as he is tackled behind the line of scrimmage.
Anytime you call an inside running play, you just know there should be a lot of congestion there. You're counting on your offensive line to take control of the line of scrimmage. That didn't happen in this case, and that play got bottled up.
Now on second and 13, Allen, and he's got his man out of the backfield. That's complete. It'll be a three-yard gain, and it'll be third and 10 now. They had the catch on second down, but it didn't help at all, and now they're looking at third down here. We've hit the two-minute mark of the first half, 10-0, our score. A reminder, once we hit halftime, as we do all season, we'll send it down to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. He'll have all the stats and scores from games in progress around the NFL.
The best multitasker in the business, the coach.
He's going to hit his man out of the backfield, complete. Now the Broncos are going to call the first of their timeouts. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. Here's Matt Wild now, as he'll kick it away for the second time. That's fielded at the 8-yard line. A nice job on the return there, 16 yards. And out will come the offense as they take over. Here's the Denver offense now as they get set to take over here. And they're coming off a three and out, my friend.
I think they've got to look at that play sheet and go to a spot that they haven't gone before. Time to shake things up a little bit to try and get this offense moving.
Okay, so how do you do that? How do you shake things up?
You look at what you've called before, realize it hasn't worked so well.
Go to something else.
And maybe you try and find one of those special plays from one of your better players, and maybe try and hit something big and get things going in the excitement area.
On first down, Love. He's got his big tight end, Fant. And a 5-yard gain gets him to the 42. Second and five after the 5-yard completion on first down. Second and five. And that's going to be incomplete. A lot of contact, no call, and it's third down.
That would have been a great catch, but it's real difficult to hold on to it because it was contested all the way. Would have been a great play if he'd been able to haul that one in.
They come up now, third and five, following the incomplete pass.
57th Mike. Go!
Come on, boy. Come on, boy.
Ready. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. A bullet throw, but incomplete. Well, the other day they told us when we've got third and five or less, we have to be able to convert. And I guess every team would say that, Charles, but an opportunity miss there.
What they were trying to tell us is they believe it's a matchup game at that point. And they liked some matchups that they had, thought they could exploit them, unable to do so on that play.
Oh, and what a play on special teams here. This is going to be down inside the five, all the way down at the 2-yard line.
That is how you flip field position. That's an absolute bomb of a punt. Downs it inside the 5-yard line. Absolutely ideal.
From that position, you're hoping to get it down inside the 15, inside the 5. Superb. On first down, they'll start out with Singletary. And I don't know if he made it out of the end zone. No signal. Yes, it's a safety. Well, I think you can go ahead and give your punter an assist on that one. Pinned him deep, and the defense comes through with 2 points.
You're exactly right, partner. This was all set up by a great punt, and if the ball goes in the end zone, this never happens. So great call. Give the punt team and the punter some love.
So they will accept the penalty and move forward.
Automatic first down.
The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. You've got less than 30 seconds left here in the half. You're well on your own side of the field. What are we doing here, Coach Davis?
Well, I'm trying something on first down, and it's something that's safe. It's something that's been done many times before. A lot of people say it's not even worth trying, but I'm running a draw. I'm running a screen. I'm seeing if something pops. And if it does, that can alter my strategy and potentially get me some points. And if it doesn't work, well, then you just run the clock out and go to the locker room.
Excellent execution, and now they're set up nicely.
Are they ever? Red zone? I wonder what the next play call is going to be, because after a big play like that, a lot of teams like to use the momentum to launch another one.
Now the Broncos going to use the second of their timeouts as they stop it with 16 seconds to go in half number one. Well, that didn't take long. One play, and we're already looking at a first and goal situation. From the gun, Love. Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete. They'll try again here from the 7 on second and goal. Here's a 2nd and 7. And that is caught. Touchdown, Denver. Noah Fant in the final seconds of the first half. And the Broncos push further out in front. There was a lot of zip on that pass, and baseball might have called that a frozen rope.
I like it when you bring the diamond into the game. I'm going back to the gridiron, had some heat on that bad boy. Sometimes you throw a touchdown pass, and sometimes...
You throw, what, a touchdown strike?
There you go. That's my man, in concert.
After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. This will be taken about the 12. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. Bills come to the line to start their next drive. Time here for likely one play, then off to the locker room, and they're going to have some adjustments to make.
They certainly will, and I think a lot of people are thinking to themselves, all right, take the knee, get out of here, regroup. But how will the head coach and his staff approach halftime? Will it be angry? Will it be clinical? Will they be calm? Will they just let it all out? Who knows? I'm going to be a fly on the wall for this one, though.
All right, Brandon, thanks. And welcome in, everybody, to our EA Sports Halftime Report. Time for a look around the NFL here in Week 3.
And we will skip the highlight show this week. Get right back to this Week 3 matchup. Broncos with a lead, and they will be receiving this kickoff here as quarter 3 is underway. This will be taken in at the 1. And he'll make it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. So here are the Broncos to take over on offense. They've won 2 straight, and they lead this one as well as they come up on 1st and 10.
He's coming.
Throwing on 1st down. Love looking for Sanders, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 38. And the return here will go to the 31-yard line. That's not one that he's going to want to remember, but he had to get it out of the way at some point, his first career interception.
And if he's the guy that they think he is, he's not laughing it off, but he's also not going to let it affect him as the game proceeds. He's going to go back out there, still be the same confident kid, the reason that they drafted him, and go out and play.
The linebacker Ryan Shazier there to make the tackle.
We got three down.
Looking to throw on second down. Allen. Under pressure, and he will go down. Sacked back at the 38. Von Miller, credit him with a sack, and it goes as a loss of six.
Okay, you know my bias is about to come out here. A lot of people think that the offense is just moving in the wrong direction. I'd say they're moving in the right direction because the defense is pushing them back.
Former defensive guy. Now, as a quarterback, third and long, you really got to rally the troops here, don't you?
Yeah, you do in a big way. And what else do you have to look out for? More pressure coming at you because it seems to be working pretty well.
They'll get 11, but it'll still lead to a fourth down.
That's certainly playing down and distance very well by the defense, isn't it? Take whatever you want underneath, by all means.
And the 12-year veteran knocks it right through, and that'll get the deficit back to 16. So a good drive there to begin quarter number three, but they're only able to shave 3 points off the lead.
Well, something's better than nothing, all right? They didn't play particularly well in the first half, but they definitely need them to step on the accelerator now and play a whole lot better.
Now after the made field goal, Hauschka back out of the field to kick it away. This fielded at the two. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. And Denver getting set to take the field. And last time wasn't pretty. One play and an interception. We'll see if they can do better.
I want to see if they want to go ahead and throw the ball again now on this drive after what happened on the last one. Throw it on the first play. Give the quarterback some confidence.
See what happens. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. Give them 14 yards there and a Denver first down.
And that's the big fella's M.O. right there. Running through tackles, keeping the sticks moving forward. This defense, if you don't bring 11 guys to the ball to try and get him on the ground, he's going to keep making runs like that. I feel the press box shaking every time he touches the rock.
A Bronco first down there, 12 yards on the play.
They're trying to show that they can run the ball, protect this lead. Give it to the backs, play a little bit of keep away, don't you think?
And that's probably a good philosophy at this point, going to make that defense stand up and stop them. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. This is Freeman. Give him a couple on the carry there, second and eight.
Doubling this guy has to be a priority before moving up to the next level because the big fella, he just ate that one alive, just stuffed it. In fact, before the game, he was talking to us, and he's like, hey, these pants make me look fat? And we said, nah, man, you're just a whole lot of guy.
He is at well over 300 pounds. He's a big man. And he's going to get this inside the 30. Give him 14 on that one and a first down.
Sometimes it's hard to believe, but there are times this game is about patience, isn't it? Has had the game he expected, but that run there, that may get him going.
I was just going to say, maybe that gives him a little juice because you're right, he struggled, especially in that first half.
Yeah, I know the great ones always think to themselves, just hang in there. I'm just one big carry away from busting this open. That's a good start for him.
A gain of three, second down.
This drive is pretty clear. Almost feels like old school fundamentals, doesn't it? Want to impose their will on the defense. What's that, five straight runs?
Yeah, five straight carries to start this drive. And like you said, the way it's working, they may just stick with it. And they'll bring him down at the 18-yard line. That one, a first down pickup of eight. A lot to praise on this drive, obviously. I know you're seeing what I'm seeing. Those guys up front, they're getting it done.
Doesn't matter what play is called. They are handling their business at the line of scrimmage and dominating right now on this drive.
This is Freeman on first and 10. And he is swallowed up right at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there. Second down.
Perfectly designed blitz right there. They took that one from the grease board to the field because they were able to free up their linebacker to get into the backfield and spill the play.
Again, they'll run with Freeman. And they'll bring him down at the 13-yard line.
Give him five on the carry there, and it'll set up a third down.
Third quarter, and you've got the lead. You're not ready to go into that four-minute offense to close the game out, but a running game can really benefit your team right now.
From the gun on third down, Love. He'll be hit and taken down at the 21.
One thing that I liked about this guy during the draft process was his motor. Of course, I loved his skills, but he plays hard on every down.
And that motor on full display there as he gets his first NFL sack. And McManus able to put it through, and that will extend their lead even further. So in the end, they had the ball for 10 plays, but the drive gets them three, not six.
Is it okay if I give credit to both sides on this one?
Absolutely.
All right, let's start defensively. They hung in there, 10-play drive, but they stiffened when they got close to the goal line, made them kick a field goal. And for the offense, 10-play drive. They might be a little disappointed they got a field goal, but they moved the ball down the field with dispatch and came away with points.
After splitting the uprights, McManus to kick it away. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Here's the Buffalo offense now as they get set to take over here. And tough to win games if you're going field goal, field goal, field goal here. They got field goal last time. Now they'll be looking for a touchdown.
They're looking for the big chunk now because, as you noted, the field goal, field goal, field goal way of doing it makes it that much harder, puts more pressure on every possession for you now. Go ahead and get six and feel a lot more comfortable about the position they're in.
Bigger chunks. We'll see if they can get the score. Play action. Now it's Allen. And he's going to lose yardage here. As they will switch ends as time has run out on this third quarter of play. Back now in Buffalo. The Bills have the football, but they trail here as we begin quarter number four. So after the sack, Allen and the Bills with work to do on third and long. Allen throwing on third and long. And the grab by Croft. And able to get this across the 20 before going out of bounds. They get only four that time as that leads us to a fourth down. They're already slim hopes are going to ride on this one. They'll go on fourth down. Allen will look to throw for it on fourth. And this is incomplete. Boy, it looked like he had it and dropped it. And the Broncos are going to get the football back in great field position. Well, at this stage of the game in the second half, down three scores, I guess they felt like they needed to push.
And let's face it, with this deficit, if they give up another score here after they didn't get it, does it really matter?
Right.
It really doesn't. They had to go and try and make something happen if they had any chance of winning this game.
On first and 10, Love. And that'll be incomplete. Deshaun Hamilton, the intended receiver. And now it's second down. The incompletion there stops the clock. Any surprise they're throwing here late?
Ordinarily, yes, because you would think enough is enough. They've got plenty of lead. But I've seen this a bunch of times as well. The defense can crowd the line of scrimmage. If you just hand it off inside, you're getting your running back popped a lot as well. Sometimes the defense dictates it. If they're going to crowd it, you may have no other choice but to throw it downfield.
Only 3 yards on the catch. It's third down. The Broncos on third down. Just 1 for 5 to this point. This is third and 7. Operating from the gun. Love. Dance. And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. Off the edge, Jerry Hughes gets the sack. He was trying to keep his eyes downfield. Nobody came open.
He was trying to do everything that he had been taught, right? Every bit of the technique. But if no one's open, there is no technique except make sure you hold on to the ball as you go to the ground when you're getting sacked.
So it's 3 more points, and that widens this thing out even further here in the fourth.
And you know, in this league, you can never have enough points. But this widens it out, as you said. And now it's all about ball control, isn't it?
That'll be taken in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Here's the Buffalo offense now as they get set to take over here. And on that last drive, went for it on fourth, turned it over. But good job by their defense, though. They held them to 3, but this offense, they've got to be a little bit better, a little bit more careful here.
And sometimes when you see these calls on fourth down, when they decide to go for it, it's not necessarily the coach saying, I believe in my offense. Sometimes the coach saying, I believe in my defense. I can afford to go for it here, because if we don't get it, I don't think we'll give up more than three. And that's exactly what happened.
You think that factored in?
I do. I think that he had that in his mind going into the game, that I'm going to be aggressive on offense because I know I've got a defense that can hold up their end.
The reception good for seven. It's third down. A second down completion got him seven. Now here's third and three. And that's complete to Croft. And he will have a first down here at about the 40. With a quick slant, good for eight and a first.
That was a route run, not just with dexterity, but with intelligence. Found the hole in the zone, made sure the quarterback saw it, and was able to make the sure catch and flip the down marker back to one.
Allen finding his tight end, Croft. Now after the completion, we're going to get a timeout, an injured player. We'll check on his status when we return to Orchard Park. So second and eight here after the pass play for 2 yards on first down. Throwing now is Allen. And this one caught by Beasley. And this is going to be another first down as they'll make the tackle at the Broncos' 45-yard line. Allen now a perfect 8 for 8 to start the second half. Not bad. First and 10. To the air, Allen. And this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down. You know, the trials and tribulations of being a quarterback in this league, it's tough. It's got to be wearing on him out there.
Well, he has been sacked a number of times. He had an interception, so I'm going to give him a skosh of credit for hanging in there and trying to make something happen, despite the amount of pressure he's been under this entire game.
Allen's throw is complete. And past the 35, he'll be dropped a yard or two shy of the 30. 12 yards there and a first down. From the 32 now, here's first and 10. Now Allen again. And John Brown's got it complete.
Holding offense.
They were looking to throw, holding on the big right tackle.
That's real simple, partner. Keep your hands inside in the chest area. You're probably okay. You get it out on the shoulders, get them wide. Usually going to pick up a holding call.
Allen's throw caught by Jones. If they didn't have that penalty a moment ago, it'd be a first down. Still a nice 13-yard pickup. To throw again on second down. Allen complete. Smith has it. And he stopped right at the 25 after a gain of 5. Just 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. So it's Bills football here as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. And that will be incomplete. Well, it just seems like all game long there hasn't been a lot of sync quarterback to wide receiver on this side of the football.
They haven't been on the same page, quarterback and receivers. Heck, they haven't been on the same grease board when you draw plays up. They haven't been on the same surface tablet that you look at on the sidelines. Nothing's worked for them. They've got to find a way to start matching each other's movements.
Well, in the grand scheme of things, those 3 points likely not going to matter much, but I guess they get a little closer, a little more respectability.
Yeah, you're exactly right. They've been outplayed all game long, but like my mom used to tell me all the time before I went out, dress up a little bit, son. Make yourself respectable. And that's what they're doing here. They're just dressing up the final score.
First down, Freeman. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. A Bronco first down there, 12 yards on the play.
I have to chuckle to myself a little bit, Brandon, because right now I could be in that huddle with that offensive line. I know exactly what they're saying. If you call a pass play here, we're going to call a timeout. Run the football. We've got control of this thing. Get in behind us and let's go.
Their time to shine. Pretty good results here on the first down run as he takes this forward for about 6. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to 2nd and 4. On 2nd down, it's Freeman. And not much of a hole there as he gets it down to about the 24-yard line.
Brandon, one thing about blitzes, They really confuse offensive linemen at times, and what you have to do is lock in on the guy right in front of you. If you don't, you saw the end result. Defensive tackle ended up making the play.
On third and two, Love flushed out right. Got a man. He finds Sanders. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. Well, a clear running situation, trying to take time off the clock. You ran the previous play, set that play action up nicely.
Boy, did they ever, because they had shown the ability to run the football. So now you lose your keys as a defense. You dive for the running play, and they hit them over the top.
Well, they probably don't need to run a play here, but you wonder if they're going to be able to resist on first and goal.
49 to Mike. It's our field. It's our field. Hey,
it's our
out. Ready, go.
That one looks like he'll throw here. And it's caught. And he'll be brought down right on the edge of the goal line at about the 1 yard line. 3 yards is the gain that time. Second and goal. Rush coming, and he's taken down. So this one will wind up a Denver victory, and I think the game balls need to be distributed on the defensive side of the football, and I bet that you would agree.
Yeah, if you hold a team under 10 points, that's a job well done, really well done. So I would say game balls for every starter and every key player who participated in this game.
Now, see, I only like one game ball.
You're handing out multiple,
although I set you up by saying game balls, plural.
Yeah,
but
yeah.
I
like where we're going with this, though. You say one to represent,
yeah,
like the best player of all,
yeah,
of that. And I say multiples so that you keep everyone motivated and involved.
You're a man of the people.
I'm a man of the people.